Hello everyone, my name is Filip Protsenko and today I'll show you how to use our newest automatic nozzle placement tool. So let's go to the workshop, create a new project to play with it and open. Now let's go straight to the irrigation tab and use some nozzle. Now with the nozzle comes a special button called automatic placement along the line. When you press on it, you go to the special mode when you draw your line and nozzles will be placed along it. So when you have drawn the line, you can click on the green button at the end and then you have to show the direction with the cursor, whether it's this side or that, and click once again. The automatic irrigation placement is done and it provides you with several options. As you can see, the green frame is now drawn over our line and you can select with the right and left button which option you want to use. Here is a few options with more and less sprinklers along that line, and then you can select accept this option or decline. If you click on green, it will be placed and ready to use. You can also reach this mode of automatic placement when you're using the normal placer like you used before, and then you can switch to this mode by clicking this button on the left bottom called automatic displacement. It's in beta now, so you can test and you cannot rely 100% on its result, but it merely works. When you click on this button, you have some options like overlaps, desired overlap, maxed out of the borders, watering and underwatering. You can play around with these options, but as this tool in the beta version, I recommend you use the normal settings, which are preset here. And then you have to click start and start with the line. Also show the direction and it will be completed. And another way to switch to this mode is when you're using the normal placement tool. You can click on tab button and you will be switched straight into the automatic placement mode. And then you can go with it. Okay, let's remove what we've drawn and I will show you now some options. For example, you can set the desired angle. If you click on this checkbox, the desired angle input will be activated and then you can start with placing the nozzles at desired angle. So now it's almost 360. Also, you can set any kind of angle and it will be placed along that line. The next thing I want to show you is how this tool interacts with already created polygons or lines. So if you draw some polygons, you can switch back to the irrigation tab, use the auto drawer, and then to stick to some line or polygon, you have to press Alt and move around and all the polygons or lines will be highlighted. And then you just click on some line or polygon and select the direction. When you're done with that, it will automatically place the nozzles along that path. Also, you can use this with the closed shape, but with some drawbacks. For example, the rectangle shape is solved very easily, but if the shape has some complexity like this, it can be a problem for the algorithm. And as you can see, it started solving, but I don't know how much time it will take.
5 minutes later.
And as I told you, it failed. And when you move a cursor on it, will provide you some information why it potentially can fail and even provide an option to retry with more loose options. But I don't recommend to do this in this case because it will still will render the same error. And what you can do is try maybe other type of nozzles. Maybe this will help in this case. Okay, and it found some solution with air van. As you can see, the solution is not 100% good, but it works. In this case, I don't even think if a designer can find a better solution. Okay, now let's go inside the area and try to fill it with the 360s. So let's select the air van 18360 and then use this tool. I'm holding the shift for it to render the streak lines. Then close the shape and select any direction. And as you can see, it worked. And you can also fill this gap and maybe other gaps you can fill on with a simple placer. So I think it will speed up some things sometimes, but as you can see, it renders sometimes error and it's better to let it go and use other options. I want to show you how this feature really works so you will understand the use cases and don't try to use it in complicated cases if you draw some or if you have some loans like these. And of course you cannot fill it with a magic automatic placement, but you can try. Of course, maybe it solves the deal sometimes. Maybe if you use some adjustable high efficient nozzles, it can render some solution in some reasonable time. But I don't recommend you to do this, please remember my words. But now this is automatic placement along the line. I don't recommend it to use it on a closed shapes. Just use it on a basic, simple use cases. But as you can see, it solved our complicated thing, and yeah, sometimes it works and sometimes it fails. So of course you can try. Here we are lucky and we got some solution, but it's never the same. Okay, and I got the last feature to show you, connected to the path offsetting. And if you have a very big path to fill, okay, let it be like this. Let's use the big rotors, let's say I-20. And then to start with the path, we need to hold Alt button and click on the path. Then choose the direction, let's say inner direction. When it's done, let's accept some solution. And now we have to fill the inner perimeter. And for this, I have a special tool for you. When you start with the automatic nozzler, you can select the original path. And then if you hold the CTRL button on your keyboard, you can navigate through the inner offsets of the path. And when you select the desired one and select any direction, you will be provided with this inner displacement solution. So that's everything about this feature. Please subscribe, like our videos, add notifications. And if you want to see more videos like this where I describe Erisketch features, comment this in a comment section, and have a nice day. Use Erisketch.